What is going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. In this video I am going to talk to you guys about the video editor that I use for editing my YouTube videos and going to show you why it is highly recommended to everyone with a simple and quick tutorial. As you guys can see, I am using Filmora editing software, and I guess most of you guys may already know that because I have mentioned about it earlier. If you don't know about this software, or if you haven't heard about it, as a quick introduction, I would say this is the best editor available for beginners and for those who don't want to spend hours and hours for editing a video. But it doesn't mean that this is just a basic editing software with limited features. If you really want to find out what this simple software can do, you just got to use it for yourself. When I started my YouTube channel, I searched the whole web for the best and easy to use editing software, and somehow I got into this one. So this is my very first video editor, and still I was able to edit videos as I wanted because of its simple and user-friendly features and tools. Then I bumped into a few other softwares like Sony Vegas Pro, but I came back to this one. Well, maybe because I wasn't satisfied with those softwares, or maybe they were not simple as Filmora. I had to spend a whole day for editing just a couple of videos. So as I said, I shifted back to Filmora because it had all the features I needed and is easy as pie. So why would me or anyone choose an alternative software? That is not gonna happen for me anytime soon. Okay, now let's get into this software and see how I edit my videos right away. To get started, make sure you have the latest version of the Filmora software. Right now 7.8 is the newest version, and download link is given below in the description. You can go to the Filmora website and click on the free download button and install it right now. When you launch the software, you will see an interface like this. You can either choose standard view or widescreen view from here. I would always go with widescreen mode, that is 16:9, because the standard view screens are outdated. You can also choose between two editing modes, that is easy mode and full feature mode. Easy modes are for those people who are lazy and wanna get a video done without any effort as quick as possible. Though I am a little lazy, I have a couple of YouTube channels to run, so I would always click on the full feature mode, and I suggest you guys to do the same if you wanna do detailed editings. As the very first step, import the video files right into the software which you wanna edit. On this right panel screen, you can preview your edited or imported videos. Drag and drop the videos one by one from the media library to the timeline to start the editing. You can also drop all of them at once, but it's good to drop one by one at a time for clean editing and to keep your timeline tidy. You can also adjust the timelines from here or like this. Well, if you are going for a detailed editing, better zoom in the timeline. With a simple click, you can rotate and flip the video, adjust the contrast, saturation, brightness, etc. You can also split the videos and delete the parts out which you won't be needing anymore. Okay, in this part, right here I just got killed, and I don't want to show it to my viewers because they think I'm a pro. So I'm gonna trim that part out and delete the video. So now I am going to add transitions between these splitted parts to make this video look even more smoother. You can choose over hundreds of transition effects, and I am going to choose this one. This is my favorite, like turning a page. Also, if you need, you could add filter effects to your videos. There are a lot of effects to choose from, and you can try everything. I am going to select this one. Just like the display, blurring display of a television. You can add as much as filters as you want to make your videos look more awesome and cool. You can also customize these filters by changing the duration or its opacity. Now I am going to the motion tab to add some motion elements to the video. Motion elements of Filmora can be used to divert attention of the viewers to the finest details of your video. A little bit of animated touch will only make your video more interesting. You can download more motion effects from the software itself, or You can buy even more from the Filmora store. Many of you guys wanted to know how I add slow motion effects in my gameplay videos or how I reverse play them. Well, with this amazing software, you can do it with just a couple of clicks. Double click on the video and adjust the motion speed from here. You can adjust the motion speed of the click to 10 times faster or 10 times slower. So here is a slow motion clip. The slow motion effects just make your gameplay videos more interesting to watch. Also, in the latest versions, you have an additional tool right here that says play video clips in reverse, which enable you to reverse play your videos. You can then adjust the motion speed of these reversed clips too. Using the slow motion effect with the reverse slow motion effect simultaneously in your video will be more awesome. We can edit videos as we actually require. It just depends on your creativity. For example, watch this. Let's say if I want to point a character of this gameplay. For that, pause the video and take a snapshot of the preview screen with the button that is right below the preview screen. This snapshot can then be accessed from the media tab. Then split the screen from where you took the screenshot. Drag the snapshot image right into the middle of the splitted parts and adjust the duration of the image. Now, for marking the character, I couldn't find any geometrical shapes or figures in the software. So what I usually do is that I would drag this text effect into the timeline and use this figure to mark him out. Now, let's watch how I usually do this.
Car. Lay my troubles to rest. Blow the smoke through my cigarette. City lights looking fine. And I know this is my time now. I'm gonna be myself, or I could be someone else. No one's stopping me now. I'm gonna skip my breaks. I'm gonna make mistakes.
Okay, so all said, and now let's watch how the video would look like. Wow, cool, right? This is exactly how I wanted it to be. As I said, it takes both your creativity and Filmora editor to create your own masterpiece. The split screen menu in here would let you play multiple videos at once. You guys may already see in my gaming comparison videos where I compare two of the very similar games. Well, for that videos, I use this split screen. You can preview two gameplays side by side for comparisons or the same gameplay with multiple view modes with this split screen tool. Also, if you create your videos with a face cam, before that let's assume that this is my face cam video, then you can drag your face cam video right into the timeline in here and adjust where and how you want your face to appear. Now after all these editings, let's get into the very important part. Let's add some text to the video. Well, if you watch a couple of my videos, you could find that I won't do much voiceovers in my videos. All I would do is add text in each part as the video progress, like the subtitle commentary. So for me, this is a very, very important feature. Filmora has over hundreds of text effects and you can download more from the Filmora store. Apart from these given effects, you can custom edit the text as you want. Well, this is the most highlighted feature of the latest versions of Filmora, that is advanced text editing. Right now, I'm going to show you how that's done. For that, choose any of the text effects. I'm gonna choose this one, this one right here. I'm going to drag it to the timeline. I just wanted the text, so I'm going to delete the background video. Now let's preview the text effect. Well, the animation is good. Now I'm going to change the size of the text. Also, I'm going to select a different font for this text. There are already a lot of text, lot of fonts in here, but we can also add additional fonts from other sites, or even you can add your own custom made fonts. So I'm going to select this one because it looks weird. I love weirdness. Okay, let's add bold. And now get to the very important part, that is advanced text editing. At first, I'm going to change the color from black and blue to black and red. I like red. And then I'm going to add black borders to the text. Also, black shadows. Now let's add this, like this text throughout the video so that I can divide it into small parts and add different texts. This is what I do when I add subtitles to a video. And now I'm going to add animation to each text. And at last I'm going to preview this text. So this is how you custom edit a text effect in Filmora. Next, I'm going to record voiceover. For this, go to the media tab and tap this record button over here. In there, you can even record yourself with the face cam. And also, if you didn't know, the Filmora can now be used as a screen recorder too. I didn't know when they added this feature to Filmora because I just found out this feature only recently. So now you don't have to install any other screen recorder in your PC if you have Filmora editor. Screen recording is very helpful when you are doing a tutorial video like this one. With Filmora, it is even easier as it automatically transfers the recorded footage into the program ready to edit. But the output will not be of very high quality because I recorded this tutorial with the Filmora screen recorder. And as you guys can see, the quality is very poor when compared to other screen recorders out there. And in case of voiceovers, you can record your voice using the microphone right into the software as your video progresses. And then you can enhance your audio using various tools like this. For voiceovers, customize the audio equalizers into a wave-like structure like this. Because according to a tutorial from Filmora, this gives the optimum audio output. And another cool feature that I always wanted in Filmora is now available in the latest version, that is pan and zoom. With this feature, you can focus on a small part of the video. You will be able to add panning and zooming movements to video clips without the camera movements, and it's gonna make your video look cool. Well, you guys may already notice that I have used this feature throughout this video. This pan and zoom feature is actually easy to use and understand, and let's see how it is done. And this is how the final edit looks like. Zoom in and out of that weapon section. There are a lot of other cool new features and tools in version 7.8, such as color tuning, where you can edit the individual colors of your video. Well, this feature is for pro editing and I won't be needing that now, so I'm not going detailed into that. Other features include save customized text and adjustable transitions, which I already talked about. And the last one is ripple delete, where you can delete multiple clicks from different tracks with just one click. This saves time and going to keep your timeline tidy. So now when your video is almost done, add some music into it, because that's what completes any video and it's more important for some background music. But at the same time, you have to watch out for copyright strikes too. Well, Filmora has solutions to the music part also. This editor has a lot of songs which are copyright free that can be used by the Filmora users. Well, I wouldn't stress that it is copyright free even when the developers claim so, because I used a song from Filmora for the background audio for one of my first videos in this channel, but sadly it was claimed by a third party. So from then I have not used a song from Filmora for any of my videos, but don't worry, there are many creators who have been using the music provided by Filmora for their videos without getting any strike. I don't know why it happened in my case. Well, no worries, I don't mind that. So by adding music, your video will be completely done. So now click the export button to save the video. You can save the video in any format, but for YouTube video, MP4 is highly recommended. You can also upload the output directly to YouTube, Facebook, Vimeo, or even burn to DVDs. You can also change the output quality from this tab. The max output quality supported is 4K, but beware that 4K output will be of very large size. So I normally prefer the normal HD or full HD videos. And finally, now you can export and save the video with this button. If you are using free trial, then there will be watermark on your videos which covers almost the full video. That would be nasty and your hard work will be in vain. So make sure to purchase it, and I am reminding you that it is the most cheapest video editor you could ever find. It costs below $40 for 1 year subscription or $49 for the lifetime purchase. So it's your choice. And with this, I'm gonna wind up this tutorial video. Now you know which is the best editing software for you. So if you found this video to be helpful, please do smash the like button and share this video as much as you can. See you later in my next video. For that, make sure you are subscribed to my channel as well. Thank you guys for watching and peace out.
I've been feeling so small. Watch the clock ticking off the wall. But tonight